and welcome to another evening of Frank Conversation here on Hard Copy, the program where we bring you the people behind the news. I'm Mawhwe Ogun Yusuf. It's been an engaging and somewhat controversial week at the National Assembly. Monday saw the continuation of a security summit hosted by the Nigerian Senate, which began last week, where it was seen that there is a gradual convergence of sorts on the issue of state policing from both the executive and legislative arms of government. How far it will go to becoming realizable is what's not clear. And much later in the week, we saw proposed amendments to the Electoral Act undertaken by both chambers of the National Assembly, some of which has raised more than an eyebrow, being adopted by the Senate. Well, my colleagues Linda Akigwe and Larry Lasisi will give you details on their program, The Gavel. Tonight, however, on Hard Copy, I speak with Senator Ali Wakili, a first-time senator representing Bauchi South Senatorial District, on these issues and other matters. Senator Ali Wakili, welcome to Hard Copy.
Good evening.
Good evening. Well, let's quickly get a number of issues out of the way. Before you joined the Nigeria Senate, you retired from the Customs Service as a controller of customs, that's right?
Yes.
Now, let me just quickly ask you a number of questions. Are you one of those who feel offended that the current controller of customs doesn't wear uniform?
I think that is a trivial issue. We are supposed to be talking about institutions, not about individuals. Individuals comes and go, the institution remains. I would think he will talk about the institution. Hamid Ali will be transient. There are people before him. There will be people after him.
Yeah.
After all, you see, the issue of the uniform came out of the blues.
Mm-hmm.
We had serious issues that were beclouded, and they were thrown away because of that beclouding of uniform. I think that is a triviality.
Perhaps it is, but then when you look at the fact that these kinds of issues often affect and becloud the major issues and sometimes, you know, affect the relationship that the Customs Service can have with the Senate, for instance, and affect important laws that should be passed, shouldn't we also take
note? If the Senate is talking about customs as an institution,
mm-hmm.
there is nothing that is going to affect any relationship between the Customs Service and the Nigerian Senate. If it is talking about individuals, perhaps it may affect, but as I said, these individuals are very temporal, whether as senators or whether as comptroller general.
So when you consider it a trivial, even though you consider it a triviality, you and the Customs Service, do you think that the CG should wear a uniform?
You see, I was placed in a very difficult position. There we are placing, if you recall, at the hullabaloo of that issue, I said I was going to be an amicus curiae. I have an obligation to the Customs Service, I have an obligation to the Senate as an institution, then I have an obligation to the Comptroller General because he's a constituent of mine.
True. So do you think he should, would you advise him to
we
wear one?
We have passed that past stage.
Would you advise him to wear one?
There are those of them that have argued that since the Comptroller Generalship is a rank within the Customs Service, ideally he should wear a uniform. He has his own reasons, and the fact that maybe if you look at the laws and the fact that the president is an appointee of the president, that the comptroller generalship is an appointee of the president, that may give him an escape route. So let us talk about serious issues that are issues bedeviling
the
Nigerian Customs Service rather than uniform.
Let us talk about the problem of welfare of the Nigerian Customs Service. I will set the agenda that we will talk about here. I'm just wondering, from your experience as someone who's been in the customs, and when you look at the fact that only recently the Senate Committee on Customs went there again, and then there was another face-off between, it was seeming face-off, you know, all, and it was seen that the relationship has just been frosty, and important issues have not been discussed over little things
Ali is a gadfly. Dino is a stormy petrel. So when you look at some of those things, you will try to make a balance. Let us progress.
How did you feel about it, though?
No, you see, I will prefer you raise the issue of bedeviling the Nigerian Customs Service rather than individuals that I told you, whether as senators or as controller generals, they will come and go and leave the institution.
Okay, do you still oppose the hike in customs tariff on second-hand vehicles? Well, you had once opposed that during the Jonathan era. You were saying something about rebuilding the middle class.
Yes.
Do you still feel that way about
I still feel it. You see, if we are trying to talk about corruption, we should be able to ensure that certain things that are very required. If you look at the transportation system in Nigeria, it's very poor. You don't have good public system. There is no mass transit. There is no good railway system. You can't go from one place to the other. Everybody needs to own a private vehicle and other things. and you discover that the middle class that are supposed to have some of those things free don't have it. When I graduated, I was given 4,000 loan, and I was able to buy a Volkswagen and whatnot. Today, it means they are giving you 200,000 loan. What kind of vehicle?
So have you been able to have that conversation with your constituent?
We have always been in dialogue with them. If you watch the television, we have always been telling them our problems. Even this morning, not a constituent of mine, but a former member of the House of Representatives woke me up very hard on me and Hamidou, that I should be able to talk to Hamidou, that they are arresting their trucks in the north where they carry 2 jerrycans or 9 jerrycans of vegetable oil that they feel is offensive, or where they carry 10 bags of rice, even where they have the docket to show that they bought it from a market either in Kano or Kaduna. He was very hard on me and other things. I asked him to follow the instrumentality of the law since he was a former legislator. Mm.